and they're very distinctive. I'm sure you can do that sound for us. You copy?
So, yeah, I can, but to be honest, it could be, yeah, I'll try. Hey, I was requested to do this bullfrog, which is good, I'll try. I'm not good on that, I'm also good on hyena call. Yes, I'm excellent, brilliant. But the bullfrog, the way they call, you can list, I mean, it's very, very easy, but I'll try to do it. But for my voice, it's not good for that. I know I've tried since while I was young. It was not good from the bullfrog itself. But we're doing like this. I'll switch the vehicle and do it for you. Because vehicle is making a lot of noise. I mean, listening to the bullfrog most of the time, you can hear them in the area. You only find them in the patch of water. Do like, hum, 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 hum. The other one, really, it's male and the female, and they're giving different sound. Sometimes you can really, they have, because of male, it's the right time for them mating. Some of them, they do release calls, some of them aggressive calls. It's differ, actually, with the circumstances of the area and also the interactions of all the frogs around in that area. But really, to understand where the blue frog, you have to listen for this vocalization that I'm giving you. You can know that there's a blue frog there and you go and hunt them because it's a lot more eatable in the area. It's very common for the traditional people to hunt blue frog and eat blue frog. I've eaten blue frog before, but this time I will never ever test it. I won't do it anymore. But it was very, very nice. I know, while I was young, it tastes like more chicken. It's something that I ate before.